Hi, Achim Schloff, Linda Space Explorers. We get a couple of requests from people asking us how to fold a lift bag and put it in a storage pack in a proper way. And that's quick and simple, so I would like to show you that today. So when we talk lift bag, we talk about this type of thing. It's a 80 lips enclosed lift bag, that's what we recommend. And then you want to put it in a storage pack. There's a couple of things you need to look for. The inlet has to be in line, in the center line. There is some of those on the market that have this square, which then creates problems. It needs to have some sort of a strap that is a little bit longer, so if the bolt snap is directly attached at the bottom, it's also difficult. All right, so what we do is, let's say this is the face, so we put it on the face. We flip one third in, the second third in, and then like this. And now the important thing is we do not fold the package. I see a lot of people doing this, but now you have to pull out the package. So what we want to do is we want to fold it in the opposite direction. So now you can see this. When I pull on the strap, it starts to unfold. And that makes it a lot easier to pull it out. So again, once, twice, and now you make sure that the outlet valve and the inlet are in line and not on top of each other. If it's like this, it's again very bulky and it will also be painful to wear it like that. So they need to be behind each other. So now you take your storage pack, you take this as a package, like this, open it up, and put this in, and then you take your hand and make sure that this is all even and there's, it's not on top. Make sure there's no hard spots, it will be a pain afterwards. And now it's inside. So the strap goes on the back D-ring. If you do a recreational dive, you may put it on the D-ring where you have your SPG. I'm personally not a big fan of that, but in a dive where you do not have stages, that can be an option. For a lot of people, it's easier to go to this D-ring and then pull it out, then go to the back D-ring. But normally, especially in technical dives, when you have stages and other stuff on the D-rings, you put it on that one. So when you pull it out, I'll show you that. You normally do not unclip this underwater when you want to pull it out. So you leave this on there and you start pulling. And sometimes you have to move a little bit, you have to wiggle it out a little bit. And then if it's loose and you let it go, you may lose it. So that's why I have it clipped in. So you pull it out and you can actually see that it unfolds. It comes out not as a package, but already unfolded. And then if it's out and you let it go, you don't lose it. So now you can reach for the D-ring again, unclip it, and now you have it. All right, I hope this helps. Next time I'll show you how to shoot it underwater, especially how ISE is shooting it underwater, because we shoot it in a team and get some underwater footage of that. I hope you like that. Please subscribe to our channel, follow us on Facebook, and I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.